Where we're healing, growing, and learning from each other. Welcome to our new studio.
Yes, exciting.
Yeah, this is new for us, and we're really glad to share it with you all today. Another thing that we're sharing with you all is the three episodes that we've released this last month. We've had three amazing guests in our studio, or not in our studio, but on our show.
Yep.
And we want to share what we've learned from them and what you can take away from them. So hopefully you'll go back and watch those videos.
Awesome. Looking forward to it. I think one of the things that I think just off the bat, we kind of kicked off the year with some really insightful things, like all over, like kind of just from getting organized to listening to your body to, you know, knowing that no matter what situation, things can always get better, and kind of healing with intention, right? I think everything, or just doing anything with intention, was kind of, we were joking around about this one time. Like, we kind of just pick that up in everything that we're like, that we talk about. So yeah, I think that's just kind of a little summary of all of it. But I think starting off with like Giselle.
Yeah, let's start with our first guest.
Yeah,
our
absolutely.
First guest was Giselle Mascarenhas, AKA the branding professor.
And man, that was what a start, right? What a dynamic start to
that
the new year.
That entire conversation was just flowy and
full of energy and
authentic,
all of it.
Yep. Just so much beauty in it. And I think that for me, that was the main takeaway.
Absolutely.
The authenticity aspect of it. Just Giselle being who she is.
Exactly.
Sharing her gifts with the world. And I think that's the message that she wants for viewers, for listeners,
absolutely.
Is to know they have magic.
Yeah.
They need to share it.
And I think that was what I was saying. Like, those words describe her. You know what I mean? They describe the way she makes you feel. But that's kind of what the intention is she's putting into her work. And and what she's wanting everybody to take from the gifts that they possess, right? That's her gift, to allow other people to recognize their gifts. So that was one of the things that stood out to me. On top of, like, you know, really hearing how what she's been through professionally, like what she's already experienced, and then her realizing like, hey, I can do this better, you know, and realizing that she wasn't maximizing her time. She wasn't, you know, as maybe
there
organized.
There was an imbalance that she talks about.
Right.
She talks about using a life wheel
to
assess where she was putting too much energy and not enough energy in other areas, and kind of reassessing her life.
Which is like something I feel like we've all, or like a lot of us, or we've talked about this between each other, and I know other people we've talked to. I think we're all in that phase, right? And so like, it's really great to have people like Giselle kind of help like reiterate that, hey, we need to do that. We need to look at ourselves. And she didn't even just look at it from a professional perspective. It was from like a health perspective too, you know. She hadn't gone to the doctor in a while, and she started doing things, implementing
eating more real food, which she calls God's food. I mean, the whole thing is just really, really good. You all really need to check it out.
Absolutely.
It's called How to Extract Your Magic, and that's with Miss Giselle.
Absolutely.
And then our second guest
was Miss Emily Joy Emily Joy Wellness, right? As we know her on on Instagram. She was great. She really was.
Gosh, such a wealth of knowledge. And like, I didn't realize how much information I was overlooking. Like how much information I have in my body that I wasn't even paying attention to. And dialing in on my menstrual cycle.
Yeah.
So just FYI, that is what the video is called. It's How to Hack Your Menstrual Cycle.
Yeah, and I clearly remember going into that interview, and I didn't know what I would be able to contribute to it or take from it, because I was like, I obviously can't relate to the topic, but it was not about that, and that's what I took from it. You know what I mean?
Right.
That I don't, maybe what I didn't have an open mind to it beforehand, and that I didn't like have the intention to learn anything about it, because I didn't feel that it applied to me. But it applies to everybody, because whether, and I mentioned this during the video, and I and I and I I feel it today is, you know, whether you're in a relationship with a woman, you live with women, work with women, whatever the case is, you know, they're around, they're in our lives mm-hmm. in some form or mm-hmm. another, and they're going through these, you know, that's nature, you know, yeah. they're going through through their menstrual cycles and all that good stuff, and knowing and being aware of what they're going to do and what going through.
That's the word right there, yeah. the awareness. I think that's the social awareness is something yeah. that we can all benefit from. And it was even an important lesson for me because yeah. in so many ways, and I'm going to tell you the second way, but first way is it's like, that's not something I really talk about yeah. in my house, you yeah. know? And I think that Emily's words really empowered me to yeah. not feel weird or nervous about bringing that up to my husband, like yeah. different things that my body is feeling and going through, because it just makes for more ease at home. Like if he knows what I'm going through, yeah. then he knows that, you know, maybe I should help her with the dishes today, or maybe there's like an act of kindness that is going to help her as she's struggling through this,
right.
you know, body stuff.
Yeah. And the weird thing about it was, is that I didn't realize like how really technical it can be, right? Mm-hmm. Like how like you literally could break it down week by week, yeah. phase, or she calling them phases?
Yeah, right? Four phases, and she recommended downloading this app. It's called the MyFlow app, and I downloaded it. So
yeah, I was like, you put that into practice already.
As soon as she told us about it, I downloaded it and I followed it.
Yeah.
And it was interesting because, you know, I was going through my, like, you know, my phases, feeling sluggish on some days. And I, instead of like wondering, like, oh, I wonder what's going on, I was like, oh, I have a resource.
Yeah.
So I would open up the app and I would, you know, look at what is actually going on inside my body hormonally. And then I was able to, it would provide suggestions like, today you're going to be feeling like this.
Right.
Don't push it too hard. Don't go, you know, run 8 miles. Eat right. foods that are going to nourish and support that.
Right.
And so, you know what happened?
What happened?
I had the most painless cycle period yeah. of like that I've ever experienced in my 30s.
Legit.
When I hit my 30s.
That's crazy.
When I hit my 30s.
Like you honestly notice like a significant like yeah. like where you're like, oh crap. Like,
no, yeah. I noticed a big difference. I even reached out to Emily and I told her about it. So really, really amazing stuff. And another thing that I want to share that she tells us in the video is that women can level up their life just like the men that we are not competing with, but
alongside with
that
yeah.
we're working alongside with, but in a more effortless way.
Yeah.
And I just love that because yeah. if you're working in harmony
yeah.
with your body, there's less resistance. It's more of a flow. And so that's what I think women need to be aware of is like, let's not resist so much. Let's right. listen to yeah. what's going on
absolutely.
In there.
Absolutely. And I think that was, that's where even, you know, you look at that from a few different perspectives, but the idea of, again, the awareness, right? Like literally working alongside, whether it's in a relationship, whether it's in a work setting, whether it's in some sort of partnership or whatever the case is, like, man, if you're aware of what if we're aware of each other, right? Whether that be on a physical note or how things are affecting us, you know, because physical things start affecting our mental outlook on things, mm-hmm. like that just makes things flow so much easier. So
yeah.
that was like what I think kept like going in my head when we were hearing that. I was like, that's
well, I'm glad.
And it's not to me what it's like, it's not simple. They're not hard things to like conceptualize, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It's just a matter of being open-minded to being aware of it, right? And
right.
wanting to be aware of it, because yeah. I think beforehand I'm guilty of like, no, I don't want to hear about it, I don't want that's that's gross or it's weird and blah blah.
Well,
but it's
I even
not,
held back right know? Now saying the word period, like it was just weird for me, but I'm like, I just need Why to get though? Over it, like that's, just say it.
It is, because you're gonna you go through it. It's literally nature, like yeah. you don't have a choice. It's like not your fault. I remember during the interview you were like, I'm sorry. I was like, why is everybody sorry? Like
yeah,
it's not like yeah it's like not like you did
not
it on purpose.
Yeah.
But
super awesome.
And I think that's a cool thing, like if you look at those two topics, that, you know, Giselle bringing that, like, being authentic, right, being real and being raw, she kept saying that throughout like every throughout the mm-hmm. going into the mm-hmm. interview, like that's how we should look at things going into, like, just the way we should live right now,
yeah.
right? I mean, everything, there's so much opportunity, there's so much things that we want, that, you know, in general we all want to be prepared for, right? Or that we want to prepare ourselves for.
Mm.
And then you get in that mindset, right? And then you listen to Emily talk about how you can really optimize your body and really make the most of that, you know, of you can level up, like yeah. she said, you know what I'm saying, and not put in so much effort if you just listen to your body. And I we were talking earlier and trying to conceptualize things. It's like sometimes you just don't know what to listen for. So when somebody gives you that education, or when somebody kind of opens that up to you, it's just kind of like poof, you know, yeah, everything yeah. just starts falling into place. So, yeah. which is a good transition to our third topic.
Yeah. Speaking of mind blowing, yeah. tell us about our third guest.
Oh man, Ayla Cuellar, your aunt, who I'm now adopting as my aunt, and she's adopted me as her nephew. That episode was so impactful on so many different ways, because powerful. I think that she represents so many things, right? Of and to me, the first word that comes to mind is resilience. I mean, her she really is a light, you know what I mean? And where there is darkness, there is light, and she's right. been through some dark right. times, you know.
Yeah, the episode was healing
from addiction.
Healing yeah. from addiction using alternative approaches. Yeah. yeah, and the healing part is really got me, because what it makes me realize is that we're all healing from something. And, you know, our title in that episode is Healing from Addiction, but you could literally insert anything. Any word in there. You could be healing from dysmorphia, mm-hmm. from anxiety, mm-hmm. from depression. Like, we're anything. All wounded yeah, in some kind of way, and we're carrying this baggage around with us. Yeah. And if we're not addressing it, we manifest
that energy or whatever
it
is. Yeah,
we manifest it in illness, mm-hmm. in addiction, yep. in, you know, obesity, right. in other, you know, other yeah. ailments Absolutely. And illnesses. And so that's what I took away from it, because I'm, you know, I'm going through my own healing journey personally. Yeah. And a lot of the things that she's practicing with in her alternative approaches are things that I incorporate yeah. in my life.
That's like, what I kept finding. And I don't think we even extended it to it in more detail. But I know, knowing you behind the scenes, right, when we're not in those conversations, but hearing the things that she was talking about, you know, meditating and her journaling and all that stuff, like, those are things you've encouraged me to do, the things that I kind of heard, like, seen you kind of take to another level throughout the time yeah, we've known each yeah. other. And it is those are tools that anybody, they're not hard, but it's the things that you can make your own, right? And they're going to heal whatever it is that you're dealing with, whatever right. it is that you need to put out there, that you need to get out.
Yeah, because I mean, there's so many tools that you can use. And she even said, I change my methodology all yeah. the time. Like, it's not like you need to stick to this rigid routine yeah. of meditation, journal, grounding, and, you know, where right. it feels burdensome and you feel like you're just checking boxes.
Right.
It's more like, feel it out, like, write it. If you need to listen to therapeutic music,
yeah.
that's another thing that she says she does. She yep. dances.
Yeah.
She goes out into sunshine and, you
she
know.
She helps others. She throws it into service, like, not necessarily having to think too much about it. But, you know, she talked about the homeless guy that lived a couple exits away, and she took, you know, sleeping bags.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And for him and his wife. And I just
feel good stuff.
And that's what I think. That's what I really encourage people. If you know anybody that's dealing with any sort of either addiction, depression, you know, like Jenna mentioned, anxiety, or, you know, dealing, you know, addicted to food or whatever the case is, like, it's a really great episode to just kind of reflect back and hear somebody talk about mm-hmm. the things that they've been through. And Ayla's been through a lot, you know yeah. what I mean? And she doesn't sugarcoat it. And mm-hmm. I love that, because a lot of other people go through some really heavy things as well, and they don't talk about it, because whether it's culturally, we don't talk about those things, or you think people are going to judge you or shun you for bringing them up. Her being so vulnerable and being so, like, I guess, willing to share
mm-hmm.
is that in itself is already a huge way to help. You know what I'm yeah. saying? And that's what was so great. And like you mentioned, not all rigid programs and things work for everybody. And the 12-step program was something that she'd been through. She definitely doesn't dog it. She it helped her, right?
Right.
It kind
yeah.
of helped her learn.
That was her starting point. And yep. I think we need to acknowledge that We all need to start somewhere. Absolutely. And we may not know the exact answer or the direction to go in, but if you don't start, you're not going to continue.
Right.
So we all need a starting point. And then from there, we can assess, does this work? Does this not work? And like she says, stay in solution.
Yeah.
Like there's always a solution, but we have to be willing to start the work.
Absolutely. And now
I get chills.
I know, because then so I was like, I was just going to say, I was like, man, what gets me is like now she's going to, her and Life Coach Angel starting, you know, the afterlife and taking their ability to heal others also and kind of spark those things to the next level is, I just can't get over how much of a impactful story that is. And I don't even think Isla realizes like the magic she possesses in that regard, because so many people really are struggling. And especially this year, you know, she mentioned it in the video that alcohol sales went up, you know, what, 30% during quarantine. Mm-hmm. And not just that, but, you know, a lot of people have turned to unhealthy habits, you know, just to cope with things. And to hear somebody talk about, you know, hey, it didn't happen overnight. You know, she relapsed and then, you know, found solutions and, you know, tried different things, but nothing was something that she completely let regress her back to starting from nothing. Like she knew that, all right, I tried this.
Yeah.
It didn't work, but let me add that and this to it. You know what I'm saying? So that's what I think, if anything, you know, knowing you, knowing yourself, listening to yourself and being aware of the things that you need to heal from, whether you know that they're there or not, but being mindful of the fact that there's something that's not completely right was really, really impactful. And I it's so weird how, like, of course we can tie all those three different episodes together, but they're also, they all kind of had the same, like there was a thing behind it all, like intention, right? Was we joke about it a lot, but it's so true. Like starting with Giselle and even Emily with your body and Ida with just your internal like self, you know?
It was like a whole mind, body, spirit month without even
planned. It was not even,
it wasn't. You know, someone asked me the other day, how do you pick your guests? Yeah. Or how do you know? Or like, I'm like, I don't. It just kind of happens. Like God calls me to talk to someone. It lines up perfectly.
Yeah.
And then happens.
Even when you and I are like talking and brainstorming, we still, that changes every time. It changes for as soon as we get there with the guests. But I think that's the beauty of it. And I think that's like the as cheesy as it sounds, that's the magic that, you know, we can extract from it.
It's the journey.
It's the journey that we're on, man. And it makes it more, that much more exciting and real, because it is. And all of our journeys are not the same, but they can be a lot more similar than we think, right? Mm-hmm. And if we work together, if we listen to each other and we kind of give ourselves that open-mindedness, so to speak, we realize a lot from each other, you know? Mm-hmm. And those, man, we're only in January. We're only three guests in. I know we have some cool stuff coming up. I don't want to go into, we don't have, I'd rather not go into those, because I want them to just come have the same moment that we had with these. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
And we'll reflect timing, back on those. The timing will be perfect.
Absolutely.
Everything is going to align the way it's supposed to. When those messages, or the guest with the message is meant to share it, they'll be here, and we'll share them with you.
Absolutely.
And I'm so excited. I'm looking forward to February.
I'm looking forward to the, like, February and the rest of the year, you know? It's so exciting that, I don't know, and we've talked about this, and I do want to put it out there, like, you know, we are blessed to have started this journey, and have the ability to have those moments with these people that have their own journey and their own magic to share.
Right.
And I'm excited to see what else we're going to learn from and grow from, because it's just as much of our healing journeys, right? Like to go alongside and have these conversations, you pick up things and you're like, man, I wasn't doing that. You know, you just mentioned you followed the suggestions that Emily gave you, and you had the painless.
I had a painless period, and it was great.
Would you have done that before? I don't know.
No,
probably not.
No.
So, it go watch, guys.
please go watch. You're gonna learn. You're gonna love it. Yeah. And
we have this new studio. Thank you so much to you and Mark also for like making this come true. This is amazing.
Collaborative effort.
Yeah.
I mean, that's how this entire process has been. Is just us sharing our gifts. Mark's got a gift of shooting and aesthetics and production.
I don't mean to cut you off, but I want to brag on that a bit, because I'm super humble. Both of y'all, like, I mean, you all are a dynamic duo for sure. Like, like outside, you guys are like for real. And I've been able to experience that. And you kind of just want to sit behind. And I'm kind of like, oh, yeah, what's going to happen? Or like, what are you all going to come up with now? And then you do like some idea and some vision. And it's all like
create together.
Yeah. And I just want to tell both of y'all like how humbled and blessed I am to be a part of this team and creating a new like game plan and a new journey, and doing it together has been just as much of the excitement of, you know, this coming year and these last three episodes. And you guys have seen too, you know, we shift and we change. Things have looked a little different, and things are keep getting better and better. And that's really, I mean, yes to you too, but I'm going to give credit to Mark for a lot of that too, because I know he pays attention to the things that we're doing in more detail than we are when we're doing it. We're coming into it from a different perspective, and that's great, because we need to come into it with that.
And I think that's the lesson here, and what I learn here, I take it out into the world. Yeah. But it really just shows you that together we're better.
Exactly.
And that we all have different and unique gifts. Yeah. That are necessary to make a project.
Yeah.
Happen.
Yeah.
And so the same goes for, you know, as we step out into the world. Yeah. Everyone is carrying a unique gift.
Yeah.
And the only way that we can make our community better and our world better is together.
Yeah, I agree.
Let's do more of that.
We're doing more of that. Absolutely. You guys do more of that too. We encourage you all to do the same. So yeah, no, thank you guys. And we appreciate you guys again so much for following us. And those of y'all that have been following us, thank you so much. If you're new to Jenna and I and Living the Journey RGV, please follow us on Facebook, YouTube, Instagram at Living the Journey RGV. We hope you guys look forward to what this year has in store for our channel and for yourselves. And yeah, thanks for tuning in.
We'll do it again next week.
Yes, we'll see you guys.
Bye-bye.